Oh, Eurovision. Sweet, sweet Eurovision. There's so many good stuff and songs. Now, I'm Canadian, but I still like Eurovision. But enough chatter. Here's the top 10 worst Eurovision winning entries. Number 10. Ireland. Fucking Ireland. Such a long time. It's the God. How has Ireland won this many Eurovisions? Like, generally? Like, they always, the ones that won are just emotional bullshit. Like, blows my fucking mind. Okay, but look, I have to give Johnny Logan some credit. He can sing. Let's be honest. He can sing. He's probably one of the best singers that's come out of Eurovision. But every time this guy sings, I shake uncontrollably and I just want to punch him in the face. Like, literally, I get this feeling, you know? He's just punchable. Look at him in the middle there. I mean, you can't really see him. It's kind of in a wide angle, but yeah. The songs itself, it's just him talking about love. So, yeah, like, literally, hold me now. Hold me now. Fuck off, Johnny. You won basically 3 Eurovisions. Let's move on. I'm not going to give this guy some more credit. Number 9. Well, this one's gonna be controversial. I'm in love with a fairy tale, even... Shit, no, that's the wrong one. Sorry guys, my bad, wrong one. God, this song is so fucking boring. I will give Nori credit, okay? They have talent, but they don't have anything interesting going on. A melancholy vocal and a depressing violin. Do I have to say more? No. I'm just bored talking about this entry, and it's time to move on. Number 8. Okay, let's just get this one over with. There's just nothing I could say. Irish, boring, love singy song. It just, like, it's a recipe to be on this list. There isn't any powerful notes. No wow factor, just a regular song you probably hear in the Billboard 100, forget about, and then be like, oh, look, this song. I fucking hated this song. Belinda Carlisle, my ass, man. Anyways, this is just mediocre. Let's just next. I don't want to do this anymore. Number 8. Well, we're finally throwing it back to the early days of Eurovision. You know, the one where everything was black and white, and, you know, color wasn't invented, you know, yet. Okay, look, I didn't want to include a lot of the songs from the older Eurovisions. But what the fuck is this shit? I am a wax doll. Like, what the fuck? Not to mention how half-assed the singing is. Hey, look at me, I'm a French girl singing for Luxembourg. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Yeah, that joke isn't funny. I know. Go fuck yourselves. On to the next entry. Number 6. Okay, and the award for I don't even need to try to put these in a list goes to this song. I mean, look, there's been bad years of Eurovision, it goes without saying, but this is just notoriously bad. And 2002 is a pretty bad year too, even though I wasn't alive yet. I think the song is pretty not great. I think the main reason it won was simply because it's a gay pride anthem, let's be honest, it is. However, we see in the later years that there were better gay pride anthems. There's not much to say. Who cares? You know, this is just a cop-out for me. Let's just move on. Number 5. Okay, I don't even remember this next entry, but fuck it. Who? When? Exactly. Aside from, like, being the most forgettable, one of the most forgettable Eurovision entries, the reason why it's in the top 5 for me is because the vocals are just fucking terrible. Oh my god, she's screaming the words. My god, why am I having a British accent right now? This makes no fucking sense. Oh, Luxembourg, look at that. Okay, seriously? Let's just sum it up. She was out of tune. And we're gonna go to number 4, because I don't feel like giving this one enough energy. Number 4.
Look at me, I'm a beautiful creature. I don't care about your modern time preacher. Welcome boys, too much noise.
Okay, if there's one song that's more annoying than Dance Monkey, I think this might take the case. God, I hate this song. This is the easiest pick on this list, and you might be asking yourself why. Well, I've had to listen to this chicken noise bullshit for the past 6 years. Why? Because I'm Jewish. And because I'm Jewish, Israel is associated with my life. And because Israel is associated with my life, garbage like this plays at many Jewish events. I'm fucking switching religions. I can't take this shit anymore. Anyways, fuck Netta. Moving on. Number 3. Alright, and coming in with the bronze, I'm gonna be super hated for this one.
I am the voice in the wind and the pouring rain. I am the voice of your hunger and pain.
Well, Ireland, once again. You can't help but piss me off. So many icks for me in this song. Oh yeah, okay, first off, I said ick, which I don't ever say, so that's one. Second, the voice, the lyrics, the performance, Michael Jackson's fucking basement. All these things is why 1996 was a rough year. Because I was totally fucking alive in 1996. The guy Mir, you seem like a nice lady. Your voice is really annoying. I feel like I'm taking LSD on this one. But you're not the worst, okay? We still have 2 more songs left. And yeah. Maybe you should go on The Voice. Fuck my life. This is why my stand-up career is failing. Okay, sorry, on to the next one. Sorry, I'm wasting time.
Number 2.
Even with the thunder and storm begins, I'll be standing strong like a tree in the wind. Nothing's gonna move.
Now, I actually feel bad putting this guy on the list. Because Dima is an artist, and I actually don't mind him, I really don't. The issue is his voice. It's terrible. It is. It was awful here. But it has gotten better in the more recent years. But I just can't believe. Okay, yeah, that one is pretty short. But yeah, Dima has said on record in interviews that it wasn't his best. He's also said that he's not gay because Russians can't be gay. said that too. Anyways, on to some honorable mentions. Truthfully, I just don't think I have, like, a lot to explain about this song. It's pretty self-explanatory why it's on here. But it isn't bad, okay? For Eurovision standards, it's really good. But for pop culture, sorry, Duncan, gotta put you on here.
Oh, mon amour, le soleil est encore...
Now, this song is called Sleep, My Love. I'm not your love, but you're putting me to sleep. Next!
Let our love shine a light in every corner of our hearts.
Look, this song is just cheesy, okay? It's not the UK's best. And, you know, just, yeah, there's not much to say. I think it's a bit weird Katrina the Wave got to do a little gig here, but whatever, I'm not gonna complain. Just not on my... Thank you, I guess? It just kind of sounds like Waterloo, but really shitty. It's just super lazy, and it's not motivated. Who cares next? To be honest, I'm actually asking the same thing. Why her? Why did she win? I don't know. Moving on.
Yo, get him next time, Cliff. I still love you. You can still win your Eurovision, Cliff. You can still do it.
Sure as hell ain't my number one. Number one. Okay, great. So for this next song, I'm just gonna play it, and you're gonna see it, and then I'm gonna end the video because I don't feel like explaining this song. I hate it. It sounds like LSD. And more importantly, I don't like the country it's associated with.
Snowdrops and daffodils, butterflies and bees.